He's shared the stage with a few names you might recognize: Coldplay, Santana, Snoop Dogg, just to name a few. And now musician Keaton Simmons is here to talk about his new EP that is coming out. Stay tuned.
You're tuning into the destination for TV superfan discussion, AfterBuzz TV. And now, let the buzz begin.
What's up, AfterBuzzers, and welcome back to another mini spotlight where we shine a light on all the rising talent in music, TV, and film. I'm your host, Morgan Willett. You can catch up with me on Twitter at Morgan_Willett. But enough about me. No one cares about me. I've got Keaton Simmons here with me.
Hello, I care about you, first of all.
Thank you.
Okay, yes.
Thank you. Well, I'm excited to have you here. But before we get started, tell everyone where they can find you on social media.
Yes, on the social media at Keaton Simmons, KEATONSIMONS. That's for Twitter and Instagram. And then Facebook is at Keaton Simmons Music.
You know, because some people still use Facebook.
I think billions of
people,
right?
My mom lives on Facebook.
Okay.
So
now you're making everyone making me feel old, I think.
Oh.
My mom loves Facebook.
I love Facebook, too.
No, I'm joking. I'm totally joking.
Anyways, okay, let's get started. One, two, three, go.
One, two, three, go is the new EP.
And it drops in March?
Ah. Yep, March 9th.
Are you so excited?
I am super excited. I'm so flipping out. I made the whole record in Nashville with an amazing producer named Marshall Altman, and I got to just like get back to myself as an artist and just spend a whole month in Nashville making a record.
It sounds amazing.
It was incredible.
Nashville One sounds so fun.
So
and just a month of making music, I'm sure, is your dream.
That is what I do. That's what I do most of the time. But it was so nice. I realized like all the records I've made have been in LA, which is my home. I'm born and raised here in Los Angeles. But I've been wanting to make a record somewhere else forever.
So what inspired this whole Nashville switch up?
Honestly, the idea came up to work with Marshall. I knew he had been there for a long time. He and I have been friends for a long time and wanting to work together forever. And it just like, I was like, boom, I saw the whole thing in my head. I was like, I'll go to Nashville, spend a month there, hang with the homies, make it happen.
So this whole EP was done in a month.
Some of the songs actually had been written previously. It's a, you know, one of them was written a long time ago actually, and then one of them, Crane City, which we just released, I wrote in Nashville while making the EP. So it was a combination of different stuff. But no, the whole thing, I mean, we cut it old school. We used the best musicians in Nashville, which is the best music city ever, and I mean, we did all the tracking of that kind of stuff live in a room looking at each other in one day of tracking for us, and then not that many overdubs, just the right stuff.
That's incredible.
Thanks.
So if you had to describe kind of the feel, the vibe of this EP, what would you say?
Well, it definitely has Nashville influence. You can feel the Nashville in there more so than a lot of my other stuff.
Okay.
It definitely leans more toward the Americana kind of rootsy type of thing. But, you know, I like to say it's about the songs. You know, it's very, very lyric heavy.
Mm-hmm.
It's just about the songs. It's just let it take you, you know. It's a good vibe, but you can feel everything. It's real. That's kind of the best way.
That's music needs to be a little more real,
yeah,
in my opinion.
Sure.
But
I think it needs to be everything.
Yeah.
It needs to be whatever it wants to be, but it shouldn't be just one or the other.
Right. So do you pull like songs from like stories of your life? Is that how you get inspired to write these songs, or
all of the above? I like to, you know, look for that very raw feeling to be inspired.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I don't close myself off. I like to be open to be able to be inspired by anything in any situation. A lot of times great art or nature is very inspiring to me, but certainly interpersonal relationships,
mm-hmm,
and my own life stories come into my songs a ton. And I learn more about myself from my music than I really put myself intentionally into my music, because it comes from such a beautiful, deep subconscious place. I think any creative artist will tell you that. And so when I you know, examine my stuff afterwards, I realize I'm telling my own story,
mm-hmm,
to myself. And I really like the insight that comes from there is something that I wouldn't be able to reach otherwise.
Huh.
And I'm so thankful. It's a deep therapy for me, you know?
Yeah, it's like free therapy almost.
Well, it's totally free. That's the best thing about music.
There you go.
Is that, I mean, if you want to buy it, it costs money, but if you want to make it, it's free.
Well, see, I can't make music, so I'm just going to have to stick to buying it. But let's talk about your song, Crane City.
Yes.
What was the inspiration behind that?
Crane City is about gentrification.
I'm big into
progress and technology. I get really into all that kind of stuff. But there are so many people who are being taken advantage of, and there's a lot of greed around it. Nashville was the perfect place to write it. I mean, I get off the plane, I'm driving to the place, and there's just cranes everywhere. In fact, I took a picture of some cranes as I was driving out over here too.
The
idea is that there's buildup and development, and when it's done right, I'm all for it, but it's all too often done in a real kind of shady way. And that's what that song is, kind of creates a voice for the people who live in those towns who just got their rent quadrupled or getting priced out of their neighborhoods they've been in 20, 30 years sometimes, you know?
Jeez. Yeah. What's the feedback been? Have fans really responded well to this song?
Absolutely. I think everyone can relate to it. The first line is, everybody's living in Crane City. You know, anybody who's living anywhere that's a developing place, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And so, you know, this song is your voice, you know? I'd hope to just gently open hearts and minds and
I love
eyes,
it.
You know?
I love it. Well, when can we expect to hear another song from you?
Pretty soon. And right here.
Oh, yeah, guys.
At the end of this interview.
At the end of this interview, we get a sneak peek, a free little concert.
Yep, of 1, 2, 3, Go, the title track from the EP, which we will be releasing as a single very soon. I'm not sure the exact release date, but it's sometime soon.
And you get to hear it here first.
Mm-hmm.
How exciting.
Yeah.
Well, before we get into that, I want to talk a little bit. You've done a lot of crazy things.
I've done some crazy stuff, yeah.
So, I mean, you've been on The Tonight Show, The Late Night Show, Ellen.
Yep.
Those are all insane. Out of all of them, did one stand out the most? Like, what's been, like, the craziest experience you can think of? Not everyone's been on all these shows.
I know. It's true. It's
this
true.
This is true.
It's all crazy. I think the craziest experience that I've ever had with, like, a late night show, like a TV show like that, was the first time I did The Tonight Show, because I think I was 22 or 23.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And I was playing with Snoop Dogg on
it's
The
casual.
Tonight Show, Leno, and you get there early, like super early, way before anything. And your first, like, rehearsal, pre-dress rehearsal thing is hours before the next one. And there's a lot of kind of waiting around, hurry up and wait kind of stuff. And you spend all day hanging around, and the anxiety just builds and builds and builds.
Oh, I'm sure.
And then you're standing there, and it's the time to be there. And you're standing there, and there's a curtain, and it's like, hey, Snoop Dogg. And then the thing opens, and you're just like, ha. And then the first time I was there, ha. And then as soon as I play the first note, then I feel comfortable.
There you go.
Know? And from that point on, I've never been quite that deer in headlights since
That's
then.
That's a big moment. Snoop Dogg.
Oh, it was so huge. I was like, yeah, it was pretty huge. I was young, too. It was
What song was it? Do you
remember? It was S&OOP. Snoop Dogg. Who that
is? Oh, my gosh. That makes me so happy. What a classic.
Oh, yeah. I got to play that. That's like, it's a way more intricate pattern than guitar players out there. That pattern is rough. It's like a 32 bar pattern that doesn't repeat.
I don't know what that means, but at 32 bars sounds intense. Like, I don't play. Okay, yes. Well, you obviously play a lot of instruments. So guitar, what else?
I studied ethnomusicology in college. That's where I did my studies in. And through doing that, I learned to play a lot of different instruments, including an entire Indonesian gamelan ensemble of instruments.
Wow.
But I play all the basic stuff. You know, I'm not the greatest drummer in the world. I play with some of the greatest drummers in the world. But I do love playing drums. Anyone will tell you, annoyingly so. I play bass a lot, and I play bass a lot on records. I love playing bass on records. I've played piano since I was really little. Guitar and stuff like that.
One man band.
Exactly.
Just do one of those contraptions where you can play every instrument.
It's the contraption that gets you. That's when you cross the line. And it's a whole different story.
Okay, so on this new EP, did you play the majority of the instruments?
No, that's actually, interesting you should say that. That's one of the things that was really liberating for me about this EP in particular. I did not play all the instruments on this EP. I played guitar and I sang lead. And in fact, Marshall did a lot of the harmonies and backgrounds and stuff like that, just to get that diversity of sound. He's a great singer. He's such an awesome dude. Marshall Altman, look him up, because he's been on every angle, you know, every perspective of the music industry, as an artist, band, touring, making records, getting signed, label guy, was the best A&R guy ever, and a producer and writer and stuff like that. Just, you know, whatever.
So he does
glowing,
it all.
Glowing, I love you, Marshall. Oh, man, amazing. But yeah, this, we had the greatest musicians in the world. I would never, I wouldn't want to play.
So did it almost take off a little pressure of you? You're like, I just to play guitar and sing. I don't have to worry about anything else.
Yes. I mean, I loved it. We did a lot of percussion stuff after the fact. It's cool because we got some footage of it, too, of us, like, making, you know, a little behind-the-scenes stuff. But yes, it did take the pressure off. I mean, it absolutely. That was the thing. I wanted to really focus on myself just as an artist rather than as a producer, as a business, as a brand, as a self-marketer. You know what I mean? I wanted to be. I didn't post on socials while I was making this record. I captured some stuff, but I wanted to really be in that moment and just save that stuff for later. I just didn't want to take myself out of it.
So yeah, and then that's so interesting though, because I feel like now musicians, do you almost feel pressure to be on social media 24/7?
Yeah, I was an early adopter. You know, I started all that stuff super early on and really, really got into it. I mean, I remember I was doing Twitter views when Twitter first started. I got some great guests too. I did Sherry Shepherd, Kevin Nealon, David Blaine. I had all kinds of people doing my Twitter views, but it was before anybody really knew and cared.
So you started the Twitter trend.
Well, I don't know that I started it. There's millions of people, but I was early and I did, in my mind, the first time the word Twitter view happened was.
Well, this is my first time ever hearing Twitter view.
Well, there you go. So now here we are.
So you really did start a trend.
Oh, yeah. And that was 10 years ago. So or more. But anyway, I don't even know when Twitter started, but I think it was around 10 years ago. Anyway, I was an early adopter. And so, yes, the thing is, at first I thought it was super great, and it was super great. And you post a thing. I remember I reminisce about it with my friends. A lot of times we'd be like, remember when you used to just post a thing on MySpace and everyone would show up at the show just because you posted it on the thing, you know, and now it's so oversaturated, such a different thing that now for me, I feel like I'm giving myself an edge creatively and artistically by distancing myself from that a little bit. Not completely. I still love it as a way to do it, but I don't want to feel obligated to do it. And that's the thing. If it feels right, I do it every time. Mm-hmm. If it doesn't, I don't every time. That's how it works.
We all need to take a lesson from that. All the social media people who feel the need to post everything.
Yeah. If you want to, go for
it. Yeah, just do whatever but if you don't want to, don't do it.
Right.
Interesting. Well, before we get to our private concert where we're going to hear this, I'm so excited. What's next for you besides this EP? Is there anything that we can look forward to? Anything you want to tell the fans out there?
Gosh, there's so much stuff. I'm going to be playing on an incredible
cruise,
Sail Across the Sun.
So fun.
Oh, my God. I can't even tell you. Sixth Man is the most incredible company. They answered the question now almost 20 years ago. 2000 was their first rock boat. They answered the question of what about the stuffy weird cruise ship thing? They're like, let's make this cool. Let's have awesome music. Let's have it be all about the fans. And here we go. And I haven't done one in forever, and I'm so incredibly stoked. It's gonna be Train, Michael Franti, Robert Randolph, and then all my friends, Pat McGee, Stephen Kellogg, Todd Carey.
So you're just gonna rock out on a boat for a couple weeks.
Rock out with the boat out. Yeah.
Rock out with the boat out. Love it. All right, well, maybe I'll just, what is it? It goes to Cozumel?
It goes, yeah, from New Orleans to Cozumel.
Oh, so fun.
Yeah.
All right, well, stay tuned for that from you.
Yeah, for sure.
And then, of course, the EP. Everyone can keep an eye out
EP,
for that.
EP, 1, 2, 3, go. And just keep coming to shows. That's all I want. I just want to hang out with you guys. I'd rather see you in person than, I mean, I love seeing you online, too, but I'd rather see you at a show.
All right, well, you heard it here. And let's get this concert going. What song are we hearing? This is 1, 2, 3, go, right?
Yeah, let's play 1, 2, 3,
all right.
Go. We might as well, huh? Hold on, let me put this strap. Right.
All righty.
When I walk these streets, I feel a certain passion. When you're there with me, we start a chain reaction and fall again. All again. I'm off my feet, I'm swept away, I'm stranded. Got my heart tethered, disbelief abandoned the hard way. I learned that hard way. You built a castle out of sticks and bones. Get back home, it's back to life. 1, 2, 3, go out.
after the months of sacrifice? Where did they go? Take time to stop and feel alive. What do we know? I know a feeling when it's right. Here alone, remember independence. We're gonna bring it all back home and feel that confidence. I love that confidence. Thinking in circles keeps my mind well rounded. Searching for subjects just to stay confounded and trying things. I'm always trying. Built a castle out of sticks and bones. Well, here we go. When I get back home, it's back to life. 1, 2, 3, go. After the months of sacrifice, where did they go? Take time to stop and feel alive. What do we know? I know a feeling when it's right. 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, go. Back home is back to life. 1, 2, 3, go. After the months of sacrifice, where did they go? Take time to stop and feel alive. What do we know? Who I know a feeling when it's right. 1, 2, 3, go. When I get back home, it's back to life. 1, 2, 3, go. After the months of sacrifice, where did they go? Take time to stop and feel alive. What do we know? Who I know a feeling when it's right.
Applause noises, but
push the button.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, incredible.
Thank you so much.
So catchy. That's gonna be stuck in my head in like the best way possible.
You wait until you hear the recording of that song. The energy of that is just, it's nuts.
Even better. Well, thank you so much for playing that. So excited. One more time, where can everyone catch up with you on social media?
At Keaton Simmons, KEATONSIMONS, or Facebook at Keaton Simmons Music.
There you go, guys. Boom. Stay tuned. This song is coming out sometime soon.
Yeah, yeah.
You got a sneak peek.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much again.
Thank
you guys for tuning into another mini spotlight. I am your host, Morgan Willett. You can catch up with me on Twitter. I don't sing, but at Morgan_Willett. And we will see you guys next time.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.